morning, everyone. It's good to see you all here. It just happens to be Easter. Yes. We have an exciting service planned for you, but we have to be honest, an announcement. So, is this announcement about?
So next Sunday, kind of Mission Sunday, we're kind of just making it Mission Sunday because we are going to have an author, a local resident, Marion Searles, come and speak during the Sunday school hour next Sunday in the fellowship hall. The missions committee is going to provide a brunch. She's going to be speaking about the mission work they do in Juarez and her book that's called Grit in Juarez. Beyond the Wall, it's about the children there and what they have to endure and also the work that they're doing there. So it should be really, really exciting. Come during Sunday school. Oh, it's two. It is. Oh my gosh. No wonder. I've got so much going on. It is in 2 weeks. It's not next Sunday. It's May 5th.
Yes.
May 5th, in my mind, is next week already. Not next week, I'm sorry, May 5th.
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Yay.
Okay.
So in the book, in the cover of the book, it says, Christ is risen. Now, that's a call, and our response is what?
He is
risen indeed. So we're going to say that a lot. Okay, I've got a magic trick with that. So Christ is risen, practice with you.
He is risen indeed.
Thank you.
hallelujah at the end of that. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's try that again from the beginning. He is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Amen. Let's stand together and sing this opening hymn. It's number 302 in your hymnal. Christ the Lord is risen today.
Presence now.
to our time of prayer. There's a few things I want to say about the pink jacket, okay? The first service, I was thinking about this. I think this is Easter. Because we're a pink jacket, right? And so, anyway, I kept seeing there's a lot of babies in the first service, and all those babies had a pink dress and a pink bow in their hair. And so I kept looking, thinking, oh, well, why is it just me and the babies? There's got to be something there. I'm not sure what it is. But anyways. Joy, I'm sure there's joy with you. You saw this sign. Our congratulations to the honeybees. They're champs. All right. Yeah. That just doesn't happen very often in time. So that was pretty exciting to hear about that. For prayer concerns, I do want you to remember Phyllis Adams and the loss of her son Trey. And also for Dave Dickerson. We want to be in prayer for Dave Dickerson. I'm going to ask the choir to call us to pray and then an Easter prayer for us. So the choir, if you call us. this Easter day, we begin with thanks. Thank you for music that thrills us, that lifts our hearts. We thank you for Easter and the victory of Easter. Although Easter will always be a mystery to us, but we thank you for it. Thank you that you hold the keys over death, and by your might, Jesus was raised from the grave. That was the death of death. Thank you that you had a plan, that you made a way. We confess this day our need for you, fresh and new. We ask that you renew our hearts and our minds and our lives for the days ahead. Let us be the light to those in darkness. For those, Lord, on our prayer list, we offer our prayers, especially for Phyllis Adams and for Dave Dickerson. Lord, we remember those today. We heard the news about Sri Lanka, those who were killed this Easter while they were worshiping. Lord, may we make a difference in this world for your glory and your purposes. Set your way before us. May we reflect your peace and hope to a world that needs your presence and healing. Thanks be to you, God, for your indescribable gift. To you be glory and honor on this resurrection day, now and forever, as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of forever. Amen. Would you stand, please? Now, this is going to take some time to do this, but okay, just go ahead and take the time, because it is Easter. So, you pass the peace of Christ to all those folks around you, and I'm going to ask the children to come down for children's time, please.
Thank you.
right here. Yeah, just stand there. You're not a prop, just stand there. Okay, now. Okay. What are these? Cascarones, right? Remember that last week I took a cascarone out, I rubbed it on my head, and I put them in little bitty plastic bags, which was my genius bend, it's my genius idea. And, anyway, it didn't work because I looked on the third floor and it's like, oh, I just opened them up and it's just a big mess. So anyway, I thought I'd still bring this, but this is not, these aren't really cascarones. These for every one of you, okay? So after church, I will give you, well, if you want them. Because I know that the mothers did not want me giving you gum. And so I have chewed a lot. Yes. Open it now. Thank you. You know I like presents like that. Okay, let's stand and have a prayer. And I'll finish up with these up here. So stand and sing a prayer. Y'all stand. Everybody stand. Everybody stand. Okay, and y'all repeat after me. Dear Lord,
for an empty tomb,
we are thankful. Thankful for Easter. Amen. Okay, so go be seated with your parents or your family back in the nursery. I will see y'all later. Thank you, Ross. Give Ross a hand. I mean, okay, let's stand and sing.
Let's do stand and sing this next hymn. It's number 312 in your hymnal, Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise.
Hail the day that sees him rise.
others, John. It's three more Sundays with us, and so it's been good to have him. He came to Tarleton when he was this big. Basically. Well, it's been wonderful having these students here in Tarleton with us. I know what you're thinking, and because I probably need to say this. How did you do that? Right? With the gun? How did you do that? Anyway, magician never reveals a secret. It is a secret. This is the holiest day in Christendom. This is Easter, so let us say that familiar greeting together one more time. The call is printed on your bulletin if you've been sort of lost so far. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
The hallelujahs are added for emphasis. Praise God. That's what hallelujah means in Hebrew. Praise Yah. Praise God. I remember reading a story about in communist Russia back in the 1920s. Nikolai Bukharin. He was a communist party leader. He was an excellent speaker, and he was sent all over Russia to really convince people of the will of the party, the communist party. He would talk about God and the state and how they really couldn't survive together. So this one meeting, he was sent from Moscow to Kiev, and for an hour he ridiculed religions, all religions in general, but especially Christianity and their beliefs. And after his speech, he invited questions and said that a Russian Orthodox priest went to the podium to ask a question. But instead, he turned and faced the people and he said these three words: "He is risen." And instantly, the assembly of thousands stood up and they said, "He is risen indeed. Hallelujah." Wow, that's pretty impressive, isn't it? Because somehow, even though it was communist Russia, somehow in their thinking, they had been raised in the Orthodox Church, and they knew the creed, they knew the call, and they knew the responses. They knew those things. They just don't go away. You just cannot root them out of people. Today, I want us to hear John's Easter story. It's in John chapter 20. Now, if you want to follow along with this, and I would suggest that you do, because you can see some subtleties here. It's on page 114 in the Pew Bible, if you didn't bring a Bible, and so that's 114. Let us hear this story together. Now, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early, while it was still dark, and saw that the stone had been rolled away from the tomb. So she ran, and she went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we," I guess she is referring to some other women with her, "do not know where they have laid him." Peter then came out with the other disciple, and they went toward the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. And stooping to look in, this disciple saw the linen cloths lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen cloths lying, and the napkin which had been on his head, not lying with the linen cloths, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in. And he saw, and he believed. As for yet, they did not know the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. And as she wept, she stooped to look into the tomb. And she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had lain, one at the head, the other at the foot. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "Because they have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." Saying this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Verse 15, Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom do you seek?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." And Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him, "Rabboni," which is teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brethren and say to them, I am ascending to my Father, and to your Father, to my God, and your God." Mary Magdalene went, and she said to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." Listen to another call for response. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How do we know what that response is? We just know, right? Because we do it over and over and over. Thanks be to God for God's word for us this day. There is something here that is easy to overlook. Maybe you heard it, maybe you read it. Resurrection happened in the dark. I want you to get that. It was dark. Sometime in the pre-dawn hours of that Sunday morning, a great mystery transpired in secret. No sunlight illuminated that event. No human being witnessed it. Whatever the resurrection was, its fullness lies in darkness, holy darkness. Somehow, in an ancient tomb on a starry night, God worked clandestinely to bring life out of death. Somehow, God enacted salvation. Today, this well-known resurrection story will be proclaimed all over the world. There's like supposedly 2.5 billion Christians on the planet. And all of them will hear this story, and most of them probably will make that call in response. There will be hundreds of thousands, trust me, hundreds of thousands of sermons today explaining the evidences and the proofs of the resurrection event. But the subtlety that we often miss, the original disciples, Mary Magdalene, Simon Peter, and John, you think it's John Zebedee, stumbled around in half-light on that third day. Early in the morning, while it was dark, that's where Easter really begins. It begins in darkness. It begins with fear and confusion and pain and a profound loss of certainty. The resurrection exceeds all of our attempts to pin it down because it's a mystery. Only God knows that mystery. On Good Friday, just a couple of days ago, we came into this sanctuary, and we were asked to sit to consider the 7 last sayings of Jesus from the cross. And it was a cross, we had it front and center, and it didn't have flowers on it. It looked rough-hewn, like it is, like it's supposed to be. We were told to look at the cross and know that it was just a bitter end. How can we see anything else? But something grand and glorious was being worked out in spite of us that day. So tonight, that night, we just said and we thank God for what God's done. God climbed down to us. God hung on a cross for us in Jesus. Why would God do that? Because God loves us. That's the most simple answer of all, because God loves us. It's similar to this day also. All we can know is that somehow in an ancient tomb on a starry night, God worked in secret to bring life out of death. Somehow from unbelievable loss and misery, God performed salvation because God loves us. That never goes away. That never stops. I like that. Listen again to the account and keep this in mind. In these verses, the author of John uses the symbols of light and dark. He does that all through his gospel. Light, dark, dark, light. And he also uses seen and not seen. Verse 1, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early while it was still dark and saw the stone had been taken from the tomb. Verse 6, Simon Peter came and went into the tomb. And he saw. Verse 8, John Zebedee also went in and he saw and believed. Verse 10, Then those two disciples, they went back home. So not much is going to change in their lives. They'll have to think about this for a while. What does this mean? What does this mean? Verse 11. Mary stood outside the tomb, and verse 14, saw Jesus. She not only saw him, but she talked with him, and she tried to give him a hug. After this encounter, she finds the apostles, all of them. And in verse 16, she says this, I have seen the Lord. From which we get the call and response, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. The point is this. Jesus comes in the darkness, and sometimes it takes a long time to see him. It takes a while to recognize him. He doesn't look the way you expect him to look. He doesn't let us hold on to our old religious ideals that we learned when we were in vacation Bible school. He wants us to change, and he's always coming to us. He calls our name, and in that instant, we recognize ourselves and we recognize him. The theologian Chris Barnes says that the question that Easter asks of us is not, it's not this question, do we believe in the doctrine of the resurrection? Because that's hundreds of thousands of sermons today, we're talking about that. That's not the question. Frankly, that's not hard to do. You've already made a profession of faith. Did you hear that? You believe in the resurrection. So? The question is this. Have you encountered the risen Christ? That's the question of Easter. Peter sees an empty tomb and he leaves, and John sees an empty tomb and he believes, but he still leaves. But Mary waits. She waits for more. Surely there's more. And so each of us comes to the empty tomb. Don't we? We all come. And what matters is encountering the risen Christ, that Jesus in our own lives. What matters really about this day is finding in the empty tomb the hope that we need for our own struggles. What are you struggling with? Can Jesus help you with that? We struggle with our losses, with our disappointments. For our Easter testimonies to ring true, they must originate in an encounter with Jesus. I've seen Jesus. I've heard him. I've felt him. I know him. May we know Jesus in the half-lit places. The shadowy places, the hard places, well, especially the hard places. May we dare to stick around. This church thing. Sometimes I think people give up too quickly on church. It's like, well, I didn't like the preacher. He wore a pink jacket for heaven's sake. I didn't like this. I didn't like that. I think I'll just go someplace else. And they go someplace else and I'm going to stay there. I think there's always something that you're not going to like. You don't stay long enough. Stick around until Jesus calls our name, your name, and until Jesus sends us forth to share the good news, his good news in this world. May our resurrection faith be honest. That's what I want to preach to you today. Just be honest about your resurrection faith and be humble about it. Happy Easter. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Would you stand? We're going to sing a verse together. Whatever your needs are, I'm going to pray.
Let's sing together number 322 in your hymnal, Up From the Grave He Rose.
Thank you.
back and just say, just shake people and say, it's Easter. It doesn't matter how you feel. It's Easter. Okay? Because this is what God has done. Not how you feel. This is what God has done. I hope you feel like that today. I hope you've encountered the risen Christ, because that's what it's about. That's what it's about. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, go in this Easter.